one will work the work of God. And Jesus said, he didn't say, even though it's necessary to fast, even if necessary to pray, he didn't say pray all night, pray all day. He didn't say go ahead and fast 40 days and 40 nights and you'll work the work of God. No, he said believe in him who sent me. And if you believe in him who sent me, then now you do the work of God. You'll work the work of God. So this is not a physical work. This is you have to believe that whatever Christ came to do, that he did it. And he did it for you. He did it for you. Amen. Amen. And so John chapter 3 and verse 14. Amen.
As Moses,
as what lift up
the serpent in the wilderness, even so must the Son of Man be lifted up.
Even so must the Son of Man be lifted up. See, this is what Jesus said now. Amen. Amen. The Bible says, amen, Jesus' his mission, and it was assignment to the world, he says, for this cause, the Son of Man was manifest into this world that he may destroy every work of the devil. And the Bible says that? And the Bible says that? That for this cause cometh I in the world that I may destroy every work of the devil. So, if Jesus is ready to destroy every work of the devil, then what you dealing with now? If Jesus is ready to destroy every work of the devil, what you dealing with right now? All you need to do is believe in him that justified the ungodly. Amen. That's it. You believe in him that if God accomplished it, he accomplished it to you, for you. For you. Amen. And then you trying to fight because two things why really that why we have not yet understand that the work of Calvary, the mission of Jesus Christ has been accomplished on the cross. The reason why we don't understand it, because number one, religion. Most of the times we get confused with spiritual and religious. Religious is not godly. Spiritually is godly. The Bible says that the letter killeth, but the spirit giveth life. The letter killeth, but the spirit giveth life. So that means that whatever the letter is, the spirit have to be also. You can't separate the word from the spirit. And that's why a lot of times we don't understand the word. What Jesus Christ accomplished, because now you got the word on this side, you got the logos, and you got the rhema, and then now you say now you speak the word, but nothing happened. You say, well, I believe it, but nothing happened, because you got the operation of the Spirit. The Spirit of God must bear witness with his word. And once there is witness between the word and the Spirit, who all is God, automatically that thing will be confirmed. It doesn't matter what it is, it will be confirmed. It will be established. It will manifest. Because why? Because the Bible says there's three things that bear witness with itself. Two things. Amen. Amen. And so we got to make sure, saints of God, that when we decreeing or making a declaration, that the declaration that we are making, that we have support by the with the word of God, that be the first support, and also the Spirit of God. Because if I'm going to understand that Jesus Christ can really accomplish it for me, amen, so I can put it into effect. Amen. Nothing can come into effect until you understand it. Amen. You have to understand it all in order to activate it. So your faith, what you understand, automatically your faith become activated because you understand. So now you can say, well, he's finished it for me. So God finished it for me. Why do I'm spending all night, all half of the night worrying about the situation that Jesus Christ has already taken care of? Why allow myself to carry so much agony and pain of a situation that God, that you meet on this earth, and before you came here, Jesus already take care of that situation. You just don't know. And that's what the enemy used. The enemy used the